everyone. So today we'll be looking at post construct and pre destroy. So these are basically life cycle methods of pin. And let's say you know like Spring IOC container inversion of control, and this IOC container will basically take care about all the activities related to pin, like all the creation, destroying, and all those things. It will take care, right? What we can do is, at the time of, let's say, our object, our pin is getting created, we want to do something, we can do that. And at the time, like, it's been destroyed, we want to do something, we can do that. So this is similar to that we have in Angular and React. We have something called as lifecycle hooks. There, whenever a component is loaded, we want to do something, we can do that using lifecycle hooks. Whenever a component is being destroyed or unmounted, we want to do something. So it is similar to that only. So what we will do is, so we have used at post construct. So this will be a function that will run as soon as the dependency injection, the auto add, is being done. So this function will run. We can do any kind of initialization there. And pre-destroy, this will run as soon as, so this is basically a callback, and this will run before the bean is being destroyed. So let's say a bean is going to be destroyed, the Spring IOC container will call this method. So what we are going to do is, so here we are, and now what we are doing is we getting the get bean here, printing the bean, and then we are closing it so that we are closing the Spring context. So we want to see whether before closing it will remove basically all the beans. It will, so that method should run. Okay, please try. So let's just run this and see what is the output here. So let's go to the program here, and we can see the last is being destroyed, and somewhere there should be like bean creation. Here we can see the bean creation. So this is being printed before even we are doing like printing the object, right? So I hope you have learned something here. Thank you.